Eczema in children is a very common problem. It's what we sometimes call atopic dermatitis. We know that around 20% of children will develop eczema at some point in their life. Fortunately, the majority of children will outgrow their eczema at some point, but for a minority, they may still have eczema going on into adulthood or a tendency to dry skin. Seborrheic dermatitis is a slightly different kind of eczema that often affects children in the first 6 or 12 months of life. Typically, they may present with thick scaling in the scalp, so-called cradle cap, but it can also give greasy scales around the face and neck, or more eroded changes in the folds of the body, particularly around the nappy area or in the neck. Eczema certainly has a genetic tendency to it, so you may find that mum or dad or brother or sister may also have eczema or a tendency to similar diseases such as hay fever or asthma. In a minority of children with eczema, we may need to think about food allergy. In these cases, the eczema tends to be particularly severe and generalised and will often start within the first 6 months or so of life. The signs and symptoms of eczema in childhood can be very marked. Usually the child is very itchy. In a little baby, they won't be able to scratch their skin, but they may have a lot of rubbing, for example, over the back of their head if it's very itchy and involved with eczema. The skin will often appear very dry and flaky, and in addition, there'll be inflammation of the skin. Sometimes the skin can become cracked and weepy. Sometimes, if the eczema has been there for a little while, there may be some discoloration of the skin, either where it becomes lighter than the surrounding skin or sometimes darker. This is particularly the case in people that have darker skin types. Eczema in children requires predominantly a two-pronged approach to treat it. First of all, you need to look at improving the barrier function of the skin, and that would be with emollients or moisturising creams. Some people would also use special moisturising washes for use in the bath, or sometimes bath oils to aid moisturisation. In addition to an emollient, one would need to treat the inflammation and the redness of eczema, and to do this, we would usually use things like steroid creams or creams such as Protopic or Elidel to reduce the redness and inflammation in the skin. There's good evidence now that maintenance therapy can really help keeping eczema under control. One would usually use the topical steroid or the calcineurin inhibitor such as Protopic or Elidel every day until you've got control of the eczema. Rather than then just stopping and waiting for the eczema to come back again, using the creams, the steroid cream or the calcineurin inhibitor for 2 consecutive days every week can be a really good way to maintain that control. And overall, you reduce the amount of steroid or calcineurin inhibitor that you need to use. Parents are often concerned whether their children can go swimming when they have atopic dermatitis. The answer to this is that yes, they can go swimming, but we'd normally recommend that they have their usual emollient applied before going in the water. When they come out, that they have a shower to remove any chlorinated water, and that their creams are then reapplied.